Would you like to customize your QuickBooks Online account so that it works better for contractors like you? Well, then in that case, you should learn how to adjust the account settings. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Now, you may well ask, what are QuickBooks Online account settings? Well, it's the automatic behavior of the software when you first sign up. You could consider it the defaults of the program, the options. Or, if you're referring to QuickBooks Desktop, this would be the equivalent of the preferences in the preferences window. The account settings window allows you to activate features that are not automatically activated when you first signed up. It also allows you to change the company name and type. It allows you to adjust the default behavior of the windows as you use them. And again, in that regard, it's just like the preferences window in the desktop version, or you can think of it as the defaults window or the options window if you were using a program like Microsoft Word or Microsoft Excel. So what will we change together? Well, first, you can put in the company name and address. So this is how you would do that. You would open the account settings in the top right by the cog wheel. Click the cog wheel in the top right to get the menu that opens for things that are permanent and things that you have to set up and prepare. Go all the way to the left, and right below the words Your Company, you can click Account and Settings. When you do that, the settings window will open up and the first tab will be selected. Now let's take a quick look at this settings window. You can click for different categories of settings to adjust different things in different categories. Again, very similar to the preferences window in the desktop version. So the first thing we will address is the company, and you could change the company name. Notice you have sections within each category separated by gray lines, and you can change anything within one section of a gray line by clicking the pencil tool. Clicking the pencil tool has the same result as clicking in the middle. It opens up that section and allows you to change it. Now, we do not have to type in Connie the contractor because we already did in a previous video when we set it up. But if you are using the Accountant's Edition and you followed the steps in the Accountant's Edition, you have the words here, Vonda Video Vixen. You have to change it to Connie the contractor. And make sure that you spell it exactly like that and keep this checked. It's the same as the legal name. We'll skip the EIN number for now. That's something that you can put in your real account once you've mastered QuickBooks Online. And then we click Save. Of course, you could always reopen it if you want to change it anytime. You will also use the account settings window to activate something called the deposit feature for clients who give partial payments to your jobs in advance of you doing any work. Now, please listen carefully. Do not follow along until I ask you to click along with me. Wait a few minutes so that I can clearly demonstrate what happens when you change this setting. So, let's close out of here. Now, I just want to show you. We will learn more about invoices later. But if I click New and open the invoice window that I promise we will learn about later, you can see right now in the bottom right, they do not have a special section for clients' deposits, for clients who pay a little bit of the job in advance before you do some of the work. But After we change the settings together, when we come back to the bottom right of the invoice window, you will see QuickBooks will add a little deposit field for you to put in the customer's deposit if they pay a little in advance. So we're going to click the cogwheel, go to Account and Settings, and go down to the category of Sales. Sales. So you click on it. Now, in this top section here, everything between the two gray lines, you have a section called Sales Form Content. And one of the choices is Deposit. Now, by default, it's shut off. Okay, you have to turn it on yourself. But if you click anywhere in here, it's the same as clicking the pencil tool to open up the entire section so you can make changes to that section of the account settings. Click the check mark on the word deposit. Do that along with me. Now I'm going to click save. And now that we have saved that setting, I'm going to click the X here and reopen the invoice window and show you the change that was made. Click New, Invoice, and when you go to the bottom right, there is now a field specifically for the customer's deposit. Now, the last setting that we'll learn about in this video is activating the Track Income and Expense by Customer setting. Please do not follow along and do not repeat. Please only watch this last section. You see, right now, if we open the account settings again, or if I did, and we went to the expense section where it says bills and expenses, right now it says track expense and items by customer. And that's already on. That feature was turned on by default. So what does that mean? That means if, now again, we're going to come to the check window later, just watch. But later when we come to the check window, you notice in the bottom right, there's a field to choose the specific customer, or really the specific project of that customer, that this check would apply to. So it does, I repeat, it does have this field here because the option, or excuse me, the settings was already including it. But just watch what I would do. If I went back to account settings, and I went to expenses and I changed it and said, do not, I removed the check mark. For example, don't do it, only watch. Do not track expense and items by customer, and I click save. That means when I go back to the check window and I look in the bottom right, I no longer see the customer field. I can no longer apply this check and expense to a particular customer because I removed that setting. So let me quickly change it back. I'm going to close the check window. I'm going to reopen the account settings. And again, you're just watching for learning. And we're going to reopen this section. Sorry, not that section. We're going to reopen. We're going to reopen the sales section. And we're going to change it back to, it's not sales, sorry. It's really expenses. And we're going to change it back to track expenses by customer. Change it back to yes, I want to track expenses and items by customer, and click save. And now, if I were to reopen the check window, I put back the field that I had taken out. And now that you know what the settings window is and how it works, you should just be aware that we will periodically come back to the settings window to adjust the settings as we need to go forward in the course.